Welcome to the Campbell Television Studio right here in Buies Creek. This is Inside Women's Basketball, and I'm your host, Evan Budrovich. We're going to use these episodes to break down the women's basketball program down to the nitty-gritty, from inside the huddle with the head coach, Ronny Fisher, to every practice to give you an inside scoop of what's going on with this team. First and foremost, Coach, this is year 30 as a coach in college basketball. How appreciative are you and this team of returning to the floor this season?
Yeah, I tell you, it's amazing just to be able to do what you love for 30 years and still have this opportunity, and to be at an institution like Campbell and get to do what I do every day is just amazing. I love it. And we've put a lot more into everything this year because we tried not to take anything for granted, because it can stop so quickly, and we learned that last year. So it's been good. Our players have we've enjoyed being on the court practicing, playing, and we're glad we've got a season right now.
Certainly Tuesday night, a dramatic game in the fourth quarter. Your team went on an 18-3 run to close out that final 9 minutes. What did it take defensively to win that basketball game?
Yeah, I tell you, it was we just really persevered, we really struggled offensively, obviously. And it says a lot about the character of your team when it's just not going well on the offensive end, but you keep fighting. I think we went down 9 or 11, I'm not sure, but we just kept fighting, and then we got some amazing stops, and we found a way to get the ball in the bucket at the end just enough to win. So I'm just really proud of the perseverance of our team, and got a lot to work on, but that was neat.
To your point, Coach, we're going to fast forward to the first three quarters and touch on the highlights of the fourth quarter.
Yeah.
Because there was some great offense down the stretch, and your team found a way to win.
Yeah.
So, Coach, right here, it gets started from the three-point line. And really early in the game, there wasn't a lot of shots, but you got to love the efforts of Lou to set up the offense.
Yeah, this is a really nice play. And what they were doing is really keying on Taya. And for Britt to step out and knock out that three was huge.
Shai Tooley's been so clutch as your leading scorer this year. A little off balance, but finding a way.
Yeah, Taya's so good on the boards. And Meek, I really challenged him because the ball wasn't going in the basket. I said, hey, we got to get the rebounds. And Meek and Taya both did a nice job there.
You got to love the passing right here from your team.
Yeah, really unselfish passing. And beautiful drive by Meek and another good three by Britt. And Shai does a nice job of taking her time here and reading that screen and just being able to score one-on-one. She's playing with a lot of confidence.
Of course, down the stretch, you needed buckets. And why not lean on a team that was getting hot in the fourth quarter, and all of a sudden, Brittany Staves having a breakout game?
Yeah, we moved the ball well here. We got it from one side to the other, and Brittany just makes a really great one-on-one move there. Tough shot.
And then your defense forcing a five-second call in the closing seconds.
Yeah, that was huge because we obviously had to have that ball back, and we were going to foul if they got it in, but we said, hey, let's try to keep them from getting it in. And here Lou is able to get to the rim and make them help, and Taya finds that rebound like she always does. She's a tremendous offensive rebounder.
And then as a coach, all of a sudden, there's a technical call in this moment, and Shai Tooley, who's been so clutch at the free throw line, what about her composure to step up and make these shots?
Yeah, I told my staff after, some people might have thought I was a crazy coach because she just missed two free throws in a row. But I have total confidence in Shai, and I know she's going to step to the line and make them. And I think our whole team has confidence in her. I don't care if she's missed one or two in a row. And it's neat to see our team up there cheering and pulling for each other. And that's awesome. That's that perseverance I talked about, and everybody supporting each other. Really proud of that. And then Shai took her time here. Shai's already made a lot of big baskets and free throws in her career, and I felt confident she was going to knock them down.
To your point, your team only shot 50%, but they made their final four free throws, and that was the game.
Yeah, that's been a little frustrating these first three games. We haven't shot well from the free throw line, but to see Shai and Lou step up and play like veterans and knock these out were huge. And I think Lou makes the next two as well. And she hasn't shot free throws well, so that's been really neat to see them step to the line under the pressure and make them.
So let's dissect this final play, because Greensboro gets a couple of looks, but a nice job to clear it out and win this game.
Well, we knew our only chance for them to win was us to foul a three-point shooter, so we weren't too worried about them getting that two there. We didn't want to give up a wide-open three, and we didn't want to foul them. So we switched out on the screens there, did a good job, and didn't give up a foul three. It's the only thing that could keep us from winning. So I was really proud of the focus there. And it wasn't a beautiful game, but I love down and dirty wins, and it says a lot about the character and toughness, and it tells our team that there's going to be days where the ball doesn't go in a basket. And we're struggling finding rhythm on offense a little bit. We're going to work on that, but you can still win games scoring 42 points. And that's the message, and there's a lot of ugly basketball being played right now all over the country. Teams that haven't practiced as much, you're trying to jam everything in and you're not getting to spend enough time on things, and it's going to take a little time. I joked the other day, we've usually had, you know, four or five games, two scrimmages, and 30 practices by this time. And right now, we haven't had that. So we're not where we need to be yet, but we're focusing on being great defensively and rebounding and being a great team. The rest of it will come, and we've got to be clicking come March. And so we're going to get there, and I really appreciate our kids, their focus and effort in that game.
We saw in a bunch of those highlights last night, but a second double-double for Taya Bolden this year. What has allowed the redshirt senior to continue to get better day in and day out?
Yeah, well, she's really worked. She's just really talented, and she can score around that basket, and she's an amazing rebounder. But she's worked a little harder on finishing through contact and focusing on her finishes around the basket and her free throws. And she didn't shoot free throws well last night, but before last night, she had shot them real well. I think she was 8 of 10 in our first game. And I think just her focus on those two things and just the confidence she's gained is big, and she's got to keep it up, and she's got to even do more for our team.
Well, Coach, we don't want to make this the Taya Bolden show, but I want to show you some clips and break down what's allowed Taya to step up as a scorer for this team. Remember, this group had no double-figure scorers last year, and all of a sudden she's putting up double-doubles a night, and it starts right here in the post.
Yeah, she's working for position, and that was a great pass by Lou. And a good screen by Shai. You didn't see the whole clip there. But she's also developed her face the basket game a little better. And she's a really tough one-on-one player to guard. Here again, we put her in a position she can score and a great pass, and she can finish around that basket.
And what's incredible, Ronnie, she's only 5'10" listed, and here she is banging down low in the post and making plays.
Yeah, well, she's really strong, and she has great timing on rebounding and her footwork's gotten better. She got a quickness down there too. It's not always your height, your quickness and your strength, and she has both of those things. She's worked really hard in the weight room, and Coach Keough has done a great job with her and all of our players, and she's gotten stronger over 4 years.
Speaking of strong players in the post, Laura McNamara Clement, now second in the country in blocks, 7 blocks this year. How valuable is her presence in the paint?
Yeah, Lauren is a tremendous defender, and it's not just block shots. She does so many little things. She handles every ball screen correctly, and she communicates so well. And then one-on-one, it's very difficult to score over. And she has gotten really aggressive on the defensive end, and she's that anchor in the middle for us. So her offense hasn't gotten to where she wants it to or where it's going to be. But her defense has really, really come along, and it's hard for me to keep her off the floor because I know how valuable she is. And so I've been really proud of her, and she's playing defensively like a senior that we need her to.
Coach, we spent a lot of this show talking about defense, but let's highlight some offense for just a second. And Shai Tooley, who's averaging a double-figure night every game for your team, taking that step as a junior. But how about this play in overtime to keep your team alive?
Yeah, it's funny. As she was going down the court, I yelled, "Go score." I just told her to go score because I wanted her to take that ball one-on-one. And I knew she would either score or get to the free throw line. And this was huge. We're down 2, and if she doesn't make this, we don't go to overtime. So really proud of her. And she's stepping up, and her defense has gotten better too. And she's a confident kid, and we've got to find a way to get her more shots. And people are going to be keying on her like they did at Greensboro last night. And now we've got to have some other players step up and finish when they're keying on her.
And finally, Coach, 2 road wins to start the season. You won 9 games on the road last year. How important is it in a season like this to have success on the road?
Yeah, I think it's really important. And it goes back to first of all, hats off to our training staff and to Kelly, our trainer, is our health is the most important thing. And all I know is we played 3 games and we've had every player available. And in this season, that's going to be the key. And obviously with COVID and also just taking care of your bodies, they've done a great job of that. And that's enabled us to get 2 tough road wins and to win in the Colonial and the Southern. Those are 2 very good leagues, so real proud of those. And now we've got to get back here and focus, change our focus to exams. Our players are in exams right now, and we'll practice some during that time, but they do a tremendous job in the classroom, and I want to give them every opportunity to be successful there.
certainly a big week for finals, then a couple games leading into conference, and all of a sudden, coaches, wrap up this episode, conference play begins. We thank you for the time, and certainly a fun couple weeks coming up.
Yeah, it's been awesome, Evan. It's great to be back out there and appreciate all that you guys do. I told our players after practice, our media coverage is as good as anybody in the country, and I love the clips that y'all put together and being able to follow it so easy on Twitter, Instagram, and everything. Really appreciate all that you guys do.
Thank you, Coach. We appreciate it.